Hello everybody. In order to determine the shift value on a horizontal axis x and y, when we use the vortex setting error compensation, we must run these lines. So actually we have to call tool in x0 and y0 and check the absolute screen. This is what we go to do. After the machine resets, we see the values on x and y axis, and we have to proceed as follows. We have to go in this table in the work. In the work set error table, we have to key in the shift value on x axis with the reverse sign. So this is step one. Now we run again the program. And now we see it's more close. But the second step is, we need a displacement on the y-axis, and we go to key it in with reverse sign also. Next we run again. So we did the tilt axis first and second the rotary axis. Now we see it's more close. Now we go to the x-axis and add the small value again with the reverse sign. But we use input with plus key. And we run again. What we are looking is that we go to have on X and Y, we go to have on zero in absolute after the reset. We still don't have it. And now we have to go to the Y axis with the value. And also input with plus. And now we will see that we will have x and y is zero in absolute after the reset of the machine. The reset is actually the end of the program. So this is the shift value on small x and y. This is delta, they call it in the book. Basically the c-axis tilts around x, sorry, the b-axis tilts around x, and then the c-axis rotates around the z-axis. I'm going to show you what is this program doing. So we send the rotary axis to the reference, and then we go with the tilt value and call the tool in the center. Okay, thanks for watching.